हेलो एंड नमस्कार, वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन एज यूजुअली गाइस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फाइव क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज। एंड गाइस, इन टुडेस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस 100% एफडीआई इन एयर इंडिया, अबाउट अ प्रोजेक्ट विच इज नोन एज ग्रीन एजी प्रोजेक्ट एंड सम अदर इंपॉर्टेंट पीआईबी न्यूज ऑल्सो। एंड ऑल्सो आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू क्विज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फाइव क्वेश्चंस। ओके, सो डू वॉच द कंप्लीट सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन विद टुडे सेशन गाइज, देयर इज वन डाउट जो कि काफी लोगों को है। सो इन यस्टरडे सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द वर्ल्ड्स पॉपुलेशन ट्रेंड्स विच वाज पब्लिश्ड इन द लैंसेट। सो काफी सारे स्टूडेंट्स को ये डाउट है दैट इफ इन 2048 द पॉपुलेशन इज 1.6 बिलियन, देन हाउ कम इन 2100 द पॉपुलेशन इज 1.09 बिलियन। ओके, हाउ कम इट इज डिक्रीजिंग? सो गाइज, आई हैव टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे दैट आफ्टर 2050, 2050 के बाद अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट the population will start to decrease, alright? The population will start to decrease and that is why in 2048, India's population will be 1.6 billion, which will be reduced to 1.09 billion by the year 2100, alright? So there is no correction in this. This is absolutely correct and I hope your doubt is clear. Now let's move on to question number one. The Ministry of Finance headed by Nirmala Sitharaman has allowed NRIs, non-resident Indians, to have 100% FDI in Air India. What is the objective of this move? इनमें से क्या इस मूव का ऑब्जेक्टिव है Air India में 100% FDI करने का? Okay. So recently guys, एक amendment किया गया है in the Foreign Exchange Management Rules of 2019 for this 100% FDI in Air India for NRIs. And this amendment guys will boost India brand India and provide global visibility, alternate sources of capital and broaden the investor base for Air India. So basically ये जो Air India है इसको एज अ ब्रांड बूस्ट करेगा, इट विल प्रोवाइड द ग्लोबल विजिबिलिटी, इट विल प्रोवाइड सम अदर सोर्सेज ऑफ कैपिटल एंड इट विल ऑल्सो ब्रॉड द इन्वेस्टर बेस फॉर एयर इंडिया। एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द बैकग्राउंड, सो गाइज, इन द मार्च 2020 इटसेल्फ द कैबिनेट अप्रूव्ड अ पॉलिसी टू परमिट फॉरेन इन्वेस्टमेंट अप टू 100% बाय दोज एनआरआईज हु आर इंडियन नेशनल्स इन एयर इंडिया थ्रू द ऑटोमेटिक रूट। मार्च 2020 में ही कैबिनेट द्वारा एक पॉलिसी को अप्रूव कर दिया गया था जिसके तहत ऐसे एनआरआईज जो कि इंडियन नेशनल्स हैं वो ऑटोमेटिक रूट के थ्रू 100% एफडीआई कर सकते हैं इन द एयर इंडिया, राइट? एंड अदर देन दिस जो फॉरेन इन्वेस्टमेंट है वो 49% ही रहेंगे आइदर डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली एक्सेप्ट इन द केस ऑफ एनआरआईज हु आर इंडियन नेशनल्स, राइट? अगर वो एनआरआई इंडियन नेशनल नहीं है तो फिर मैक्सिमम लिमिट कितनी है? 49%। अदरवाइज इट हैज बीन इंक्रीज टू हाउ मच? 100%। ओके, एंड according to the new rules, the amendment removed the exception which permitted overseas citizens of India 100% FDI in air transport but not Air India. इससे पहले air transport में 100% FDI था for the overseas citizens of India, लेकिन Air India में नहीं था. But now, ये जो overseas citizens of India है, इसको replace कर दिया गया है NRIs के लिए and now उनको कितना allow किया है? 100% FDI in air transport including Air India through automatic route. All right, this is the new rule. And if you talk about the role of RBI, so guys, RBI will have full autonomy to issue or interpret the rules regarding 100% FDI or of NRIs. Aur isse pehle jo hai consult karna padta tha with the central government, but now RBI will have the full autonomy in deciding the rules regarding 100% FDI of NRIs. Okay, and now Shaktikant Das is quite happy that finally he is having some autonomy in their functioning. Okay, so now let's move on to the question. Question is, guys, what is the objective of this move? So option A, boost brand India and provide global visibility. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Alternate sources of capital and broaden the investor base for Air India. Yes. To increase income and employment. Yes. To provide ease of doing business in the country. Yes, this is also correct. So guys, all of these are the objective of this move. So option E is the correct answer. Now let's move on to question number two, which is about the high levels of ammonia that was recently detected in the Yamuna River. So the question is, what is true about the ammonia contamination? Ammonia contamination ke baare mein hume correct statement batani hai out of these three statements. All right. So let us first discuss the news. So recently, there were high levels of ammonia that was detected in the Yamuna River. And due to this, Delhi Jal Board had to reduce its water pollution capacity by 25%. And we all know about ammonia, guys. It is a colorless gas having formula NH3. Alright, and it is used as an industrial chemical in production of fertilizers, plastics, synthetic fibers and etc. जो इसकी maximum permissible limit है, maximum एक्सेप्टेबल लिमिट है इन द ड्रिंकिंग वाटर एज पर ब्यूरो ऑफ इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड्स, इट इज 0.5 पार्ट्स पर मिलियन. एज पर BIS इन द ड्रिंकिंग वाटर द मैक्सिमम एक्सेप्टेबल लिमिट ऑफ अमोनिया इज 0.5 पार्ट्स पर मिलियन. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द कंटामिनेशन गाइस, सो इफ द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ अमोनिया इज अबव 1 ppm इट इज टॉक्सिक टू फिशेज. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द ह्यूमन बींग्स, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट अस, सो अगर हम बहुत लंबे समय तक ऐसा पानी पीते रहते हैं जिसमें अमोनिया का लेवल 1 ppm या उससे ज्यादा है तो इट कैन डैमेज टू आर इंटरनल ऑर्गन. ओके, एंड द मोस्ट लाइकली सोर्सेज आर एफ्लुएंट्स फ्रॉम डाई यूनिट्स, डिस्टिलरीज एंड अदर फैक्ट्रीज इन पानीपत एंड सोनीपत डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन हरियाणा, एंड सीवेज फ्रॉम सम अनसीवेड कॉलोनीज इन द स्ट्रेच ऑफ द रिवर. सो दीज आर सम एंट्री पॉइंट्स ऑफ अमोनिया टू द यमुना एंड दीज आर सम कंटामिनेशन फैक्ट्स अबाउट द अमोनिया. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट वॉज द क्वेश्चन? Question was we have to find the true statement about the ammonia contamination. Okay, the acceptable maximum limit of ammonia in drinking water is 0.75 parts per million. No, it is not 0.75, it is 0.5. Okay, concentration of ammonia in water is above 1 ppm is toxic to fishes. Yes, this is absolutely correct. For humans, ammonia levels of 1 ppm or above may cause damage to internal organs. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So therefore guys, the correct answer should be what? Option C, only 2 and 3. Now let's move on to question number 3, which is about the Green AG project. So recently Union government launched the Green AG project in Mizoram. Which state is not included among the 5 states where the project will be implemented? Okay, in which kaun sa wo panchwa state mein se ek state nahi hai. So recently this project has been launched in Mizoram and it will be implemented in 5 states like which are Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Uttarakhand and Mizoram. And this project guys has been launched to reduce emissions from agriculture and ensure sustainable agricultural practices. हमें अपने agriculture से निकलने वाले emissions को reduce करना है और जो हमारी agricultural practices है उसको sustainable बनाना है. Alright. And this project guys seeks to integrate biodiversity, climate change and sustainable land management objectives and practices into the Indian agriculture. Now this project is funded by the Global Environment Facility, which is an outcome of 1992 Rio Earth Summit. 1992 का जो Rio Earth Summit था उसी के outcome है Global Environment Facility, and it is an organization which looks after all the environmental problems across the world, and it is located in Washington. Alright, Washington में ये located है, and the national executing agency for this project is the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare. एंड इसके अंदर कुछ और भी प्लेयर्स हैं जो कि पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे लाइक फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चरल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड ऑफ कोर्स यूनियन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज. इसका जो पायलट प्रोजेक्ट है दैट इज सपोज टू बी एंडेड बाय 31 मार्च 2026 इन ऑल स्टेट्स एंड इट एम्स टू कवर 35 विलेजेस एंड 2 प्रोटेक्टेड एरियाज विच आर द डंपा टाइगर रिजर्व एंड थोरांगप्लांग वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी. बोथ ऑफ देम आर इन मिजोरम. ओके, जो डंपा टाइगर रिजर्व है और जो थोरांगप्लांग वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरी है वो दोनों के दोनों कहाँ पे? मिजोरम में है. ओके गाइस, सो दिस इज अबाउट द ग्रीन एजी प्रोजेक्ट. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज विच स्टेट इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड? सो राजस्थान, मध्य प्रदेश, उड़ीसा, उत्तराखंड एंड मिजोरम, दीज आर द 5 स्टेट्स. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट गाइस? ऑप्शन ई, हरियाणा. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. According to the report released by Washington-based World Federation of Direct Selling Association, Global Direct Selling 2019 Retail Sales, what is correct about India's direct selling industry's performance? So, एक report है जिसका नाम है Global Direct Selling 2019 Retail Sales, जिसको दिया गया है World Federation of Direct Selling Associations द्वारा. So, हमें बताना है कि what is correct about India's direct selling industry's performance, okay? So if we talk about the world's performance, so global direct selling industry has reported a decline of 4.3% in sales in the year 2019. And these are the top 5 countries. You must not remember this data and you must not remember the contribution. Bas aapko top 5 countries bhi agar yaad ho jati hai, then that is more than enough. Rank 1 pe it is US, rank 2 pe China, followed by Korea, Germany and Japan. These are the top 5 countries and India's rank is 15th. Alright, India's rank is how much? 15th. And if you talk about India's sales, so direct selling industry has recorded sales which is an increase of 12.1% from the year 2018, jo ki kitna hai 2.47 US dollars. India's rank in direct selling improved to 15th in the world from 19th a year before. And if you talk about in terms of the number of direct sellers, India has been ranked at 6th position. Aur jo India ka CAGR hai, yani ki compound annual growth rate, कंपाउंड एनुअल ग्रोथ रेट जो है वो भी काफी ज्यादा है. इट हैज रिकॉर्डेड द हाईएस्ट सीजीआर ऑफ 16.3% ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ लास्ट 3 years. सो इंडिया इज परफॉर्मिंग वेल इन देयर डायरेक्ट सेलिंग इंडस्ट्री. ओके सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज करेक्ट अबाउट इंडियाज डायरेक्ट सेलिंग इंडस्ट्री परफॉर्मेंस. So option A is in 2019, it shows an increase of 12.1% from 2018. Yes, this is correct. So I think this must be our answer. Let us read out the other options also. India's rank in direct selling improved to 10th in the world from 19th. No, it is 15th, not 10th. So this is incorrect. In 2019, it shows a decrease. No, it shows an increase. In 2019, India's direct selling industry recorded lowest CGR. No, it is not lowest. It is the highest CGR. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option A. And now, guys, let's move on to the last question for today. Question number 5, which is about the aerial seeding method that is useful because there are many areas that are either difficult to reach or inaccessible to get altogether. So the question is, which state's government has employed this technique? Kaun si state government ne is technique ko employ kiya hai? So recently Haryana government has employed aerial seeding techniques to improve green cover in the Aravali areas of the state. Jo Aravali areas hain state ke wahan pe green cover ko badhane ke liye aerial seeding techniques ka istemal kiya jayega. Isme hoga ye guys ki drones ka istemal kiya jayega for the seeding. Okay, because ye ilake kuch aise hain jahan pe pahuncha nahi ja sakta. These are the inaccessible areas. So in these inaccessible areas, with the help of drone, Haryana government will do the seeding with the help of drones. Okay, so this method will be useful since there are many areas that are either difficult to reach or inaccessible. And as a pilot project, this project is being carried out in the Aravali and Shivalik hills. Okay, and this method involves spraying seed wells or seed pellets from the air using seeding drones. And single drone can plant 20,000 to 30,000 seeds a day. And this method, guys, is being implemented on 100 acres of land to test efficacy of the seed dispersal mechanism. Okay. So this is about the aerial seeding, and the correct answer is what? Option B, Haryana. Haryana's government has employed this technique. This question, guys, is very important for NABARD. NABARD ke liye kafi important hai, and ye ESI section mein bhi pucha ja sakta hai of the RBI grade B. And now, guys, let's move on to the quiz section for today. And again, I'm not giving you options because this is quite different method. Although I know ki is tarike ka question exam mein nahi aayega, is tarike se is pattern se question exam mein nahi aayega. बट येस इस तरीके से आपका जो मेमोरी है उसका काफी अच्छा टेस्ट किया जा सकता है. ओके सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज दैट व्हिच स्टेट हैज शोन मैक्सिमम डिक्लाइन इन एमएमआर इन द पीरियड 2016 टू 18. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इज यू गाइस कीप आंसरिंग. आई विल फर्स्ट रीड आउट ऑल द क्वेश्चंस देन आई विल टेल यू द आंसर्स. ओके व्हिच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज रिसेंटली रिलीज्ड द यूएन मल्टी डायमेंशनल पॉवर्टी इंडेक्स. इन व्हिच स्टेट निष्ठा प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन ऑनलाइन मोड. Decarbonizing transport project was jointly launched by which two organizations? And World Bank Group has launched which program to improve the quality and governance of school education system in India? Okay, so now let's move on to the question number 1 and let me tell you the answers. Which state has shown maximum decline in MMR in the period 2016 and 18? This state, guys, is Rajasthan. Chief Minister is Ashok Gehlot. And which organization has recently released the UN Multidimensional Poverty Index? This organization is United Nations Development Program, UNDP. UNDP, it is located in New York and it is headed by Asim Steiner. Asim Steiner is the chief of UNDP. Now, question number 3. Recently, NISHTA program has been launched first time in the online mode in which state? So, this state, guys, is Andhra Pradesh. We have discussed it. Andhra Pradesh mein first, sabse pehle isko online mode mein launch kiya gaya hai. Decarbonizing transport project was launched jointly by which two organizations? Guys, these two organizations, one is Niti Aayog, and other is International Transport Forum, which is located in Paris. Okay, and the last question is, World Bank Group has launched which program to improve the quality and governance of school education systems in India? So the name of the program, guys, is STARS, and STARS stand for Strengthening Teaching, Learning and Results for the States. Strengthening Teaching, Learning and Results for the State is the program, and this has been launched by the World Bank Group. So these are the 5 questions for today's quiz, and please share your marks in the comment section. And guys, Rakhi aa gayi hai, you all know, so log on to anujjindal.in and you can use code Rakhi30 to avail a huge discount of 30% on all our courses of RBI, SEBI, NABARD and UGC NET. And for more information, call on this number. And for guys more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट सेशन में. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.